We're going to examine skeletal muscle innervation. But first, we have to talk about the muscle fiber types that form a muscle, and they fall into two main categories. First, we have the large contractile muscle cells, known as the extrafusal muscle fibers. These are the muscle fibers that are controlled via alpha motor neurons, shown here, to generate the contractile strength of a muscle. The alpha motor neurons branch and innervate individual muscle fibers within what is called a motor unit. And there are multiple motor units within a given muscle. Now, there are also another much smaller number of muscle fibers known as intrafusal fibers. Those are shown in the lighter color here. And these intrafusal fibers are part of a sensory structure called the muscle spindle. It is involved in what is termed proprioception. Proprioception is the sensing of position or movement in space. And so what this muscle spindle does is it has afferent axons, in other words, sensory neurons that are wrapped around these muscle fibers in the middle of this muscle spindle. And when this muscle is stretched, those afferent fibers generate action potentials, telling us that muscle length is changing, and in this case, increasing. That will create reciprocal contractions of the extrafusal fibers to protect against that stretch, and we'll talk more about that later. Now, the intrafusal fibers are also innervated by gamma motor neurons. In other words, we can initiate their contraction as well. Now, their contraction is not to contribute to the overall muscular strength, the overall muscular tension. Their contraction is stimulated to adjust the sensitivity of this muscle spindle apparatus. For instance, when a muscle contracts, the muscle spindle could become slack or more slack, in which case changes in muscle length would be less detectable. So we need to keep some tension on these intrafusal fibers through the gamma motor neuron actions to make sure our muscle spindles are functioning properly.